Well, good morning, everyone. Thank you very much for returning for the second and full day of ISID's annual conference. This year, the theme of unpacking women's empowerment in international development. It's my pleasure at this time to open the second day of the ceremony, or of the conference rather, by introducing to you the fearless leader of McGill University, Principal Suzanne Fortier. Suzanne Fortier has served as the Principal and Vice Chancellor of McGill since 2013. Prior to her appointment, Dr. Fortier was President of the Natural Sciences and Engineering Research Council of Canada from 2006 to 2013, and also held the position of Vice Principal Academic and Vice Principal Research at Queen's University. She was also a professor in the Department of Chemistry at Queen's, the first woman ever to be hired by the department in 1982 and in the School of Computing. Dr. Fortier is a native of Quebec and graduated actually from McGill with a Bachelor of Science degree. She won a National Research Council of Canada postgraduate scholarship and entered directly into the PhD program at McGill, where she specialized in crystallography and graduated in 1976. I think at that time she probably did not know that she would later return to McGill as the fourth ever alumnus to become principal. Dr. Fortier has received several awards for her work, including the Clara Benson Award for Distinguished Contributions to Chemistry by a Woman, and the Queen Elizabeth II Diamond Jubilee Medal. Principal Fortier also holds honorary doctorates from Thompson Rivers and Carleton Universities, as well as a university close to McGill, the University of Glasgow. She is an officer of France's National Order of Merit, a fellow of the American Association for the Advancement of Science, and was named a specially elected fellow of the Royal Society of Canada in 2015. I'm going to just go on for one more paragraph. In 2016, Principal Fortier was appointed to the Canadian Federal Minister of Finance's Advisory Council on Economic Growth, as well as the World Economic Forum's Global University Leaders Forum. She also serves on the Board of Directors of Montreal International, the Conference Board of Canada, Universities Canada, the Pierre Elliott Trudeau Foundation, among several other boards and councils. Now, I should say that I first met Principal Fortier when she arrived at the university and was introduced to the Senate of McGill. At the time, I was serving as a senator. And I just have to say that my first impression of seeing Principal Fortier participate and introduce and welcome people was that she's a genuinely warm and very genuine, open to honest debate and criticism, as well as ideas. And she's completely dedicated to this university. I think I've not witnessed, at least in my time at McGill, a more dedicated person to the mission, the academic mission of the university. She's a very strong advocate for our research. She is also a great supporter of female faculty and the progress of the university in dealing with many of the challenges that we'll be thinking about here today. So please join me in welcoming Principal Suzanne Fortier.
Merci Catherine, merci beaucoup Catherine et merci à vous tous d'être ici aujourd'hui. Distingués invités, chers collègues et amis, j'aurais aimé vous souhaiter la bienvenue, ce qui aurait dû se faire hier, but as you know, unfortunately I was out of country, so I'm very happy to be here today to say bonne continuation, because all I've heard this morning was extremely enthusiastic remarks about the first day of this conference. I know that you've had some fantastic speakers who have really brought very important thoughts for the discussion and have really nurtured great engagement with the topic that is the topic of the conference, unpacking women's empowerment. It's such an important topic. We know around the world that we need to have a conversation about the role of both genders and in responsible leadership and in encouraging the development of progressive values in the world. We around the world need to reduce inequality. And this is a goal, as you know, a very strong goal of this country, and it has to be also a goal of all of us in the world. I hope that you've seen the work in Canada most recently expressed in our budget. So people always say money really does talk. And so in our budget, it was great to see the gender results framework being introduced. This is just a month or so ago. So there's a lot of good things going on, but there's a lot more that needs to be going on. And I'm very happy that you are here to participate in this work. Let me take just 1 second to say how proud we are at McGill of our Institute for the Study of International Development. It has experienced fantastic growth, very significant growth. And I would like to thank all of the people who've been involved in that. Of course, the directorship, the faculty members, the International Advisory Board, the support staff. But first and foremost, perhaps, I would thank the students. Because an institute like this lives because it is able to attract students who are highly devoted to the study that they are able to embark on in the Institute. This is the core, this is the heart of the Institute, and we're very fortunate here at McGill to have many, many of our students who are deeply committed to international development and come to our university to study in this area. I believe it is one of the highest, maybe not the highest, but second highest program in terms of its enrollment at the undergraduate level. So I think this is great that we have people who are really devoted to this area. And I'll end with something that is both a call to action, but also, I think, an acknowledgement of a profound challenge that we have in this world. I had the privilege just a few months ago to attend the World Economic Forum in Davos. The theme of the conference was creating a shared future in a fractured world. And I think both part of the sentence are important. We do live right now in a deeply fractured world, very, very worrisome. But at the same time, we should not take that as a way of feeling pessimistic and imagining a dystopic future, but rather as a call to action. And the call to action is creating a shared future. I think we all know that we can't create a shared future as long as some people are left behind. If women are not participating to the extent they ought to the extent they should have the opportunity to, we are not creating a shared future. And if people from different countries do not have the opportunity to participate, we will not have the ability to create a shared future. So I think we need to work at this, making sure that we do something to remove those fracture points in our world. And being an optimistic person and seeing what I see here on campus, among the students on our campus, I think we will get there. We will get there because there are generations now of young people who more than anybody realize that and want to do something about it and are putting right now their talent and their energy in learning how they're going to do something about it and doing it. So ça me laisse beaucoup d'optimisme de voir cette génération d'étudiants qui sont sur nos campus à travers le monde et qui ont cet engagement-là de créer un monde beaucoup plus uni que celui que nous avons maintenant, un monde plus inclusif. Alors, I hope that you are seeing this here at McGill and everywhere you go in the world, that we have this generation of young people who are wanting to create such a world. Merci beaucoup.